those flippers like feet when they're on land, but then has flippers below with their tail when they're in the water. So at this point, as our otters go ahead and finish up their meal with their toys, I want to thank you all for supporting this really important work that we are doing here at the aquarium with the sea otters and helping them to support the wild population behind the scenes. And as I mentioned, we have Diane, our volunteer, out there. If you want to talk to her about sea otters, she's got some samples and different things she can talk to you about. So thank you all for coming to the aquarium today. My name is Pam. I'll be out there in just a moment, and this is a great time for those of you up front.
Introduce everyone to this exhibit. This is the open sea. This is 1.2 million gallons of water. That is a lot of water. So to help explain everything about this big environment, I have these two large screens on either side of the exhibit. What you're seeing right now is a flyover of the ocean, but up there, this is the top view of this exhibit. Now, standing up there is my friend Lauren and Renee. Allá hay mis amigos Lauren y Renee, y nosotros vamos a hablar un poquitito sobre lo que vamos a hacer hoy. So let's check in with them. There we go, there is Lauren, there is Renee. Lauren, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, Renee, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien. How's it going up there? What is on the agenda today?
It is great. Now today I'm up here with Renee Carvajal, one of our aquarists. Good morning, Renee.
Buenos días, Lauren. Buenos días a todos. Bienvenidos a esta exhibición. El Mar Abierto es una de las exhibiciones más favoritas, la exhibición más grande aquí.
That's right. It's one of my favorite exhibits as well. Renee, up next, we're about to feed the UP's largest exhibit here at the aquarium, the Open Sea. Now, Renee, tell me, what is on the menu for these animals?
What about I take it from here? Looks like we're just seeing that food hit the water, so will I see you down here in just a minute?
Sounds great, and of course you will.
All right, thank you, Lauren. Now, folks, I know it's really sad to see Lauren go. If you take a look inside the exhibit, you're going to see some food being tossed and plenty of excitement happening right now as well. Let me just talk about some of those fish in there, those long, skinny fish with crescent-shaped tail. Those are our dolphin fish. Now, they get that name because they are often mistaken for being dolphins with that long, slender body. Now, if you're not seeing dolphin fish on boats, if you're seeing dolphin fish on your dinner plate, you might know them by their restaurant name of Mahi Mahi. So this is muy delgado. Se llama dolphin fish, pero también se llama Mahi Mahi. So if you're like eating Mahi Mahi, that is actually what you're eating at any restaurant. Now, they also have a third name, dolphin fish. Mahi Mahi. They also go by their Spanish name of Dorado. So in Espanol se llaman Dorado. I know we have a few Spanish speakers out there. Can you all tell me qué significa Dorado in English? What does that mean? I hear over there, golden. So that means golden in English. You might be wondering, why would they name a gray fish gold? So if you look at that fish, it looks great, but they can actually change colors. They can be brilliant shades of oranges, yellows, and of course, gold. So esos peces pueden cambiar su color a ser dorado. Now, does anyone recognize what food we're tossing into the water right now? It's quite fantastic. That is squid right there. California Market Squid. This is actually the same exact squid that you would be getting at any restaurant here. So we have the same suppliers that come here in the morning and then they just go to any other restaurant here in Monterey, of course. Now, if you like eating seafood, if you like eating Mahi Mahi, continue eating Mahi Mahi because, of course, it's delicious, but it also has the potential of being a very sustainable source of seafood. Believe it or not, this fish starts out life at the size of a grain of rice, and within 2 years, they are full grown. They're about 90 pounds big within just that short span of time. So they are a very sustainable source of seafood. Now going to other fish in the exhibit, those more football-shaped fish, those yellow thin tuna, those are the true athletes of this exhibit. So they can actually swim at about 50 miles per hour. Now, I'm gonna put that into perspective, all right? 50 miles per hour, so Michael Phelps swims at about 5 miles per hour. This is how we feed her. That is a visual dinner bell. She is super polite, comes up to that visual dinner bell. She gets little pieces of salmon. So, una pieza de salmón, or that super duper cute, right? And there she goes right again towards the middle. So that is how our pelagic ray eats. Now if you're just joining us, I want to show everyone how that mola feeding went at the beginning. Also a little bit of a closer view. So again, draw your attention to those screens. This is the mola mona. So in Pez Luna, or the sunfish right there, comes right up to those targets. We take that sausage. That gel sausage, we just hand feed it right to its mouth. Very, very cute. All right, so look inside the exhibit. What you're seeing hit the water, in the water, that food is actually chopped up sardines. So esa comida es sardinas. Now we also have a school of 25,000 sardines in this exhibit. Se puede mirar el banco de 25,000 sardinas allá for those people in the front row. Now we're feeding sardines. We also have a school of live sardines inside the exhibit. So parents, have the circle of the plankton. Right now, really, really good time to have that circle of plankton together. For a few seconds to get that talk out of the way, all right? All right, you guys have enough time. So the most asked question we get, superficie, no se puede mirar a unidad de ustedes. So that's going to fall down against them and hit the sardines on the head. That mole school will come up. They're getting about 30 pounds of food today, so 30 pounds for about 25,000 sardines. Again, very, very important to stay in that school. We're going to see that school go up. Now, they might do a little bit of yo-yo action. This is kind of like the smell of the bacon in the morning. Looks like I'm seeing the sunfish come up right here, really, really close to me. So as far as I'm fast, Luna. So that's a mola mola. Kind of looks like those hot cakes with wings, of course, a ceramic dinner plate. Looks like someone just gave up on design of that fish. That fish is about 1 year apart. Actually, the biggest bony fish in the world. They can get over 5,000 pounds. And look at that. As I'm talking about that whole school of 25,000 Pacific sardines has come up. Esa es 25,000 sardines. You might be wondering, how do I know that that is 25,000 sardines? Well, we have a college intern. Yeah, every morning comes to the class for dinner. Now, super important to stay in this pool of 25,000 sardines, because out there in the ocean, out in the open sea, there's nothing to hide behind. No rocks, no seaweeds. You basically have to hide behind each other. So they hide behind 24,999 of their bestest friends. And they said, well, I hope James gets eaten today and not me. Now you might look at that school. You might ask me, Nick, which one is in charge? Well, actually, it's pretty easy to see the sardine that's in charge, all right? So take a look at that school. The one that's in charge is the silvery one. It's about this big, it's swimming. I'm serious though, because all of them are in charge. None of them are in charge at the same time. They have organs in their bodies that detect vibration in the water, allows them to stray away or with those schoolmates, which keeps and forms these wonderful random schools. So I want to do a scientific experiment, okay? We're gonna pretend that we are a giant dolphin fish. We're gonna try to catch a sardine and eat it for breakfast or brunch or lunch, whatever it is time for you. So I want everyone to just pick out one sardine. We're gonna follow it for 10 seconds. The amount of time that it might take you to chase down the sardine, grab it, and then eat it. All right, ready? Everyone got the sardine? I'll do the countdown. Set, go. 10, 9, 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, does anyone still have eyes on their sardine? Couple of hands out there. Look at me for a second. I'm a big shark about to eat you. All right, now where's your sardine? All right, so you can see it's really, really hard. So with that, that's why sardines stay in school. Kids, stay in school, all right? So.
I want to be the starfish. Look at that. Look at the starfish. I want to be
the
I want to be like a black bird.
I would want to be that.
Wait, are you seeing the penguins? These aren't penguins.
They're puffins.
Puffins.
Thank you.
so weird. It's like night over.
Okay. Thank you.